Ooh, suit up sequence. Okay. We saw this in an ad, though. Let's see. Oof. At least, like, dry him off first, man. It's gonna stink in there. Kenobi's not an idiot. Kenobi didn't stay in that cave for 10 years. We all know this. And I think it was better the Legends way, where Obi-Wan saw pieces of Empire propaganda and said, oh crap, that's him. And then had to be doubly safe and doubly careful. I still think that's better. My mind is never going to change on that. Criticism of the fact that Reva should not know who Vader is aside, it's still better thematically, and it helps to show how big the galaxy is and how fast information can spread, especially from, like, a position of a tyrannical monarchy or something. It just works better. I'm glad that out of all the stuff from the Legends canon that Disney chose to reject, I'm glad we still kept the Mustafar lava evil villain castle. Even though narratively and thematically it would not be appropriate. I don't think Vader would like that very much realistically, but hey, whatever.
He will pay for the Grand Inquisitor.
The Grand Inquisitor means nothing. Kenobi.
So he is dead. So he is dead. They just Control-Alt-Deleted Rebels from the canon. That's what this is leading us to believe. I'm just trying to think. What do they stand to gain from doing that? Because sure, Rebels is a bit garbo here and there, but like that got you a lot of Disney Star Wars fans. People became complicit in the childish idiocy of the writing in Disney Star Wars because of how much they like Rebels. Like, Rebels, if anything, groomed the majority of the Disney Star Wars fandom you see today into their ways. Why would they spit on that legacy? I see it as a bad thing, but many people like Rebels, so who am I to judge? It makes me wonder, is all the animated stuff not canon? Is that what they're trying to subtly say? Because I know Star Wars Visions is other universes or other timelines, so that I'm fine with that not being canon. But is Clone Wars not canon? Is that upcoming Jedi Tales not canon? I have so many questions.
Prove yourself, and the position of Grand Inquisitor is yours.
No. Vader is shown quite frequently in the comics, movies, etc. And when I say comics, etc., on the side of movies, I'm referring to Disney's as well, because Disney has been quick to flood the mainstream with as much as they can to cover up the gap that they left when they decanonized Legends. That said, Vader is a no-nonsense, no-failure type guy. The planets you could fill with the bodies of people he has killed for failing him. Yeah, so please explain why he didn't force choke her through the hologram and kill her.
Fail me, and you will not live to regret it.
She's already failed you twice, though. This just looks like California. Red Rock Canyon, California. Or Nevada, one or the other. Screw you, Disney. Stop teasing. So, that's nasty that they gave us a bit of a tease with a Jedi robe. Again, I hate that they keep doing that. Just give us Qui-Gon, damn it. Bring back Liam Neeson. Even as just a spirit who does nothing, bring him back still. And then, on top of that, but there's a good thing in that scene. I did say earlier that I hope that that first snippet in episode one of his PTSD isn't the only thing we get. I hope it actually is there. And so far, they've kept up the fact that he is in fact suffering from PTSD a little bit.
I am the next in line.
I love how all the times they've seen the Force used in this show, with the exception of one instance where he saved Leia. He saved Leia, and that was like the only useful use of the Force in this show. Other than that, there was the really stupid parkour choreography, the stupidly flagrant, unnecessary parkour choreography, and then this. It's like Disney doesn't understand the Force.
Oh, that's embarrassing.
Send out the probes. Do it now.
Use the Force. Make him. Throw them around. Do something!
My pleasure. Hop in!
I do like his design, the sort of star-nosed mole.
Don't worry, I'll get to the port in no time.
This is what happens when unions back fascists. Biden voters.
They're moving us around, looking for a Jedi.
A Jedi? Out here? I hope we're not in any danger.
No, we'll find them. We always do.
Haha, stormtroopers are stupid.
Are you sure he's even on this planet?
They know what they're doing, Leia.
You called her Leia. I thought her name was Luma.
Of course, Obi-Wan is the idiot
that
who screws
her
up
mother's
the message.
Name.
Are you my real father?
I wish I could say I was. But no, I'm not.
It's a bit of a stretch, but yeah, I'd want you and McGregor to be my father, too.
Who are they?
A couple of strays I found. Thought you might want to check them out.
Aw, he is slimy. Bummer. I get it, Obi-Wan's not mighty with the Force anymore, because he's slightly disconnected. And again, he's not trying to attract attention. But I don't see how a blaster causes less noise than a lightsaber. Okay. I am surprised that Disney is showing a stormtrooper getting sliced in half. And I'm also pleasantly surprised that Obi-Wan just RKO'd Freck. Freck. Freck? Freck. Yeah, Freck is in Freckle.
These days, the Empire hunts anyone who's Force-sensitive. Even children.
What happens to them?
We're not sure. No one ever sees them again.
Dead or Inquisitors. Right now, at least. Later on, it's just dead.
Yeah. He helps now and again, smuggling younglings.
Wait, who?
Quinlan was here.
Oh, yeah, Quinlan
he
Voss. Okay.
Again. Smuggling younglings.
Nice. Love to see it. No, Neppy.
Open up now.
Don't kill Neppy. No. Don't do something stupid. He was really about to do it, but he's like, I'm not that boy. I'm not the main character.
Okay, Ben? What is it?
He's here.
Ugh. Those gloves did not look good, but the rest is looking fine. Just the gloves. The gloves are the one thing that made my brain go, no. Yeah. Yeah, everything else looks fine. It was just the glove. The glove looked a bit odd and out of place. Yeah, for those of you who don't know, Darth Vader is like Batman. He looks the same in every movie, but that's because your brain recognizes him, like, in a general sense. If you actually, like, take an image from multiple movies and shows, he's very different in little details, and whatever suit they took those gloves from doesn't match well with the rest. In my opinion.
Holy
Joe. Okay.
I'll lead him away.
Okay, so he is drawing him out, but he's gonna... Hopefully that's all we see of Leia. Hopefully. An unceremonious departure of Leia would be fitting of the tone that they are claiming they are trying to create. The director went on the record saying she's trying to create a Logan Joker style series, and so far the tone has not been matching that. Until about, like, halfway through this episode when a stormtrooper got sliced in half. I feel like this episode might be where the hat's falling. So, in fitting with the tone they claim they are trying to create, that would be the perfect off point for Leia. Step off, leave the show. Now, I don't know if it's going to happen this episode or the next one or the one after that. I was promised a rematch. And Kathleen Kennedy was real ballsy with her wording. She said, like, something along the lines of, like, it will match the hype of the prequels or something like that. I want to give you the benefit of the doubt, girl, but you all have been underselling on a lot of your promises. So, let's see. Let's see. Nice to see they fixed the hand positioning. Really? Really? Almost at the end of episode 3. And only now has Obi-Wan drawn his lightsaber. Almost halfway through the series, and he's only drawn his lightsaber once.
I am what you made me.
Yes, swinging wildly is what Vader is known for in the Age of the Empire. What is this music? Like, this music feels very anticlimactic. And what is with all the shaky cam, bruh? Also, that's a lovely pause shot. Wow, Vader's the only one using the Force in a way that makes sense.
When you had the chance.
You should be like, a quip that I would let them get a... Interesting choice of editing. Wow, I'm a god with the pause today.
Now you.
That's a derpy shot.
Obi-Wan.
This, I could see Vader doing this, yeah. Use the Force. 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 Yep. Obi-Wan Kenobi not using the Force and being weak in it due to his years of losing faith is something I will be complicit in. It is something I will understand, it is something I will empathize with and partially allow, even though I personally don't think that the Obi-Wan we saw at the end of episode 3 would turn into this thing. Darth Vader is the chosen one. He is a cannon tank of force energy, and right now he is amped up on hate on the dark side, which means he should be insane. Insanely strong right now. We just saw how he tortured Obi-Wan, how he throttled him like a rag doll and scorched him in half. And he can't grab a droid? He can't grab a droid? He can't crush a droid. He can't grab his master again? He's just gonna stand there.
Oh, that's embarrassing.
Why we just saw what we just saw is because Disney, as usual, has its diversity checklist. We can't have a strong white male lead. Which is why the first red flag I saw was Kathleen Kennedy greenlighting a Obi-Wan show. Sure enough, we have a cinematically catastrophic calamity of canon right here. This scene where Vader acts out of character. Obi-Wan is already 3 episodes into acting out of character. And then Vader acts stupid and weak. They had to nerf Vader in the power-wise and the mental brain-wise just so a woman could save Obi-Wan Kenobi. Now, let's rewind a bit and rewrite the scene and show you how you can have a woman save Obi-Wan Kenobi but still have good writing. Obi-Wan is actually fighting. Obi-Wan, of course, in this hypothetical, Obi-Wan would also have to be written well, but in this hypothetical, Obi-Wan is fighting. They're fighting, and Obi-Wan's biggest problem is he can't get away from Vader. What do we see? We see that woman come in, shooting her pistol. We get a flash. We get a reference to the original trilogy where Vader's blocking the shots with the Force in his glove, like when Han Solo tried to shoot him. And Obi-Wan takes the opportunity to run after she says go. Obviously, this would be her having to heroically sacrifice herself, but he could get away, in theory. Instead, we have whatever the hell this is.
Unfortunately, they couldn't make it, but I'll take you from here.
How? Use the Force! Deborah Chow, you're a hack. You're all hacks. Hope you never get any more work again. Okay, so it is still James Earl Jones. Dang. Nice to see he still got it. He didn't really have it in Lion King anymore. But, like, he's got it here. Love to see it. That was my episode 3 reaction. That was fun. That one was just under an hour. Because there was so much nothing happening. I just had to sort of let it happen. Yeah, this is a 2. This one's a 2. Star Wars characters behaving like idiots on screen at all times. It's very frustrating. Almost nobody uses the Force in a way that would be tactically efficient. They don't. They refuse to, and I don't know why, and it's very, very frustrating. Obi-Wan prefers to use a blaster as opposed to his lightsaber. And, Grand Inquisitor is dead, so they just control-alt-deleted rebels from the timeline, apparently? And that's coming from someone I didn't necessarily like Rebels, but Rebels sat comfortably in its own little space. But now, arc one villain of Rebels is just dead now, I guess? Like, what, is he a clone in Rebels? Is that what they're gonna retcon it to? Or are they just not gonna address this? Yeah, this is probably the last piece of Star Wars media I'm going to consume. Mandalorian had a cute baby, but it was laughably badly written. Book of Boba Fett, laughably badly written. Last season of Clone Wars was okay, but they brought back the people who were already making Clone Wars and just gave them a higher budget. So that's not really Disney. You could give Disney credit for writing the check. You can't really give them anything else for that. Like I said, Rebels is really, really dumb. There's not really anything good there. And, it looks like Kenobi will be where I'm stepping off the Star Wars train. I'd be lying if I said the show was beyond saving. There's still 3 episodes left. And, they could save it. They could. But that would involve, like, Kathleen Kennedy putting story first. And she never does when preparing for a show, because it has long since been confirmed that they have a diversity and virtue signaling checklist quota. That you gotta follow that religiously. And then care about story. By the way, the Darth Vader bits? It's getting very weak now. I feel like we have hit a crucial point where George Lucas was correct in his approaches. You could say what you will about story details in exactification, but there are very few instances where George Lucas appreciates or condones something transpiring between sequels. Was I hyped for the Obi-Wan movie back when it was going to be done by George Lucas? Yes. Yes, I was. Was I hyped when Disney revived the project and said it's going to be a show? No. Because I knew it was going to be like this. And I don't... There's very few ways this can be saved for me. I'm very, very, very concerned going forward. And I just don't see how Disney's going to carry it, but we'll have to see.